2024 is shaping up to be a great year for Metroidvania. With so many amazing new Metroidvania games being released, I decided to make a list of the best Metroidvania games of the year so far in mid-2024. Well, let's get into the list.
I am a shaman, my father.
Venture to the File is a Metroidvania game with a really amazing art direction. The town of Rainybrook feels spooky yet thrilling. It really immerse you into its wild world. The game's design reflects the deep experience and wisdom of its developers. The puzzles, platforming, and combat are seamlessly interconnected, enhancing each other in a beautifully crafted web. While you may notice a few rough spots in this game, its charm and dedication shines through where it matters the most. The Weird Dream is a captivating Metroidvania set in the eerie ruins of Alpha City. In this game, you play as a mysterious rabbit, fighting through mutated inhabitants and uncovering the dark secrets behind the city destruction. While the game might have some rough edge, its combat is truly satisfying, and the movement upgrades are both logical and incredibly helpful. If you want to try some Metroidvania hidden gems, definitely give this one a shot.
Rise to fight evil once again.
Pampas and Celine, The Maze of Demons is a charming retro Metroidvania game that takes on the 1987 classic The Maze of Gallus. One standout feature of the game is the co-op experience. The co-op mode is exceptionally well designed. Each character has unique abilities and can explore the castle separately, with a picture-in-picture view. It's really cool that you can play this game with your friend locally. Grab a buddy and dive into this adventure together.
Face to face with the terrible demons who oppose them.
Moonlight Pulse is a seafloor game second Metroidvania game, and once again, they deliver an exceptional experience. One of the coolest features of the game is the character switching. I love swapping between characters multiple times in mid-air to chain together movement abilities or attacks. It made the gameplay so dynamic and exciting. The game may be short, but if you are looking for a quick, enjoyable Metroidvania, give Moonlight Pulse a try. Frog Monster is one of that rare FPS Metroidvania, and it's quite a good one at that. The game's world is vibrant and alive, filled with unique encounters and rich ambience. I was especially impressed with the boss fights. Unlike typical FPS bosses where you just shoot until it's down, each boss here felt fresh and challenging. If you love both Metroidvanias and FPS game, then this game is a must-have. Airhead is a puzzle platformer focused Metroidvania. In this game, we control a headless body that discovers the deflating head, and we have to save it because it's missing a crucial body part for breathing. To progress, you will need to control both the head and body, sometimes together, sometimes separately, to solve puzzles and overcome obstacles on your journey. This game offers a unique and thought-provoking experience, especially due to its innovative puzzle mechanics. The Mobius Machine is a sci-fi Metroidvania set in an alien world. First off, the visuals are stunning. With so much going on in the background, something you don't always see in other Metroidvania games. It really immerses you into this alien sci-fi world, clearly a labor of love from the developers. While the gameplay may feel repetitive at times, the game still delivers a solid Metroidvania experience. Despite minor flaws, its engaging exploration and satisfying progression will keep players hooked. The Devil Within Setgate may still be in early access, but the game already feels really smooth. If you enjoy well-crafted combat in a Metroidvania with diverse skills, this is among the best new games available. It has great parry mechanics, and the boss fights is really thrilling. Overall, it's shaping up to be a great game, and I can't wait to see how it evolves. Biogun is a unique twin-stick Metroidvania where you dive into a dog's anatomy to combat a virus that threatens the canine species. Biogun's captivating and fun gameplay will keep you hooked. The ability to customize your gun with collectibles upgrade and badge adds a nice touch. On top of its amazing gameplay, it has charming protagonist, and the world, even its gritty parts, is visually appealing. This is another amazing early access Metroidvania, with potential for more greatness as development progress. Rebel Transmute is a charming indie Metroidvania created by a solo developer. If you are a fan of Metroid-inspired adventures, this one's got a lot to offer. It's packed with perks and unique abilities that set it apart, blending nostalgia with fresh mechanics that will keep you hooked. The atmosphere in this game is also spot on. It's colorful without being too distracting, and the environments are immersive. Exploring the world in this game feels rewarding, with well-paced rewards around every corner. Turbo Kid is a direct sequel of the movie with the same name, and it captures everything that made the movie great, reimagining the narrative perfectly for a video game while expanding the world in exciting ways. The gameplay is solid once you get used to it. You will bike around the wasteland, slicing through enemies in a gory yet humorous way. All in all, this game is fantastic, truly living up to both the movie and the Metroidvania genre. Biomorph is a unique Metroidvania where you have the ability to transform into various enemies that you have defeated. Each form grants unique abilities essential for navigating obstacles and solving puzzles, keeping gameplay dynamic and requiring quick thinking. In addition to that, the characters are well developed, combined with charming hand-drawn animations that bring the world to life. Its innovative shape-shifting mechanics, coupled with a rich narrative and beautifully crafted world, ensures it stands out in the genre. Tales of Kenzira is a touching Metroidvania that delves deep into themes of death, grief, coping, and acceptance. Death is a constant companion for the main character, Zhao, who encounters it at every turn. Through his journey, he learns not only to accept death, but also to perceive it as a natural part of life, a continuation within an ever-turning cycle. Powerful, beautiful, and featuring mechanics that are both accessible yet challenging to master, Tales of Kenzira brings a refreshing twist to the Metroidvania genre.
I can't do this, Kalunga.
Altros is a fresh and intriguing take on the Metroidvania genre. Unlike traditional Metroidvanias, Altros introduced a refreshing twist with a loop system that keeps the gameplay fresh and engaging. Some people mistake it for a roguelite, but it's not. It does borrow some of its elements, like a cycle loop that ties into the story, but it's truly in a genre of its own. It's almost genre-defying. Momodora Moonlit Farewell is a heartfelt finale to the amazing Momodora series. The game is stunning. It's more polished and visually impressive than its predecessors. Furthermore, it excels at tying up loose ends and referencing previous titles, making it a treat for longtime fans. But don't worry, if you are new to the series or haven't played the earlier titles, the librarian in Koho Village offers notes that summarize the previous stories, providing all the context you need to enjoy this game. Whether you are a longtime fan or new to the Momodora world, this game has a lot to offer. Mini-Shoot Adventures is a top-down bullet hell Metroidvania that truly nails the key elements of the genre. It has all the things that made a great Metroidvania. One of it is its captivating level design. The game is filled with hints to hidden secrets and new paths that open up as you gain new abilities. This design will keep you hooked, constantly exploring, looking for friends to save, shortcuts to unlock, and heart pieces to collect. At its core, Nine Souls is a peri-focused Metroidvania with heavy emphasis on its narrative. First off, this game is hard. It's not unfair, but it is challenging. The enemies is smart, especially the bosses, who will try to corner you, so plan your move carefully. Secondly, the story is also amazing. What I love is how creatively they tell the main story and build the world. You get a lot from in-game dialogue and character memories, which not only expand the lore, but also the depth of the world itself. Ender Magnolia: Bloom in the Mist is the sequel of the popular Metroidvania title Ender Lilies. The game improved in almost every way from Ender Lilies. The combat feels much smoother now, and it flows really well. Another good thing to point out is that this game still retains Ender Lily's beautiful visuals and music. This game is shaping up to be a masterpiece. I can't wait to get its full release. Animal Well is a thrilling Metroidvania filled with puzzles and mysteries. With no dialogue to guide you, it's up to you to navigate the game's enigmatic world. It's a game for the curious explorers, the one that have no problem walking the same path over and over again in hope to find something new each time. The game does not stop delivering rewards for your thoroughness, and each discovery felt rewarding and satisfying. As a AAA Metroidvania, Prince of Persia: The Lost Crown truly delivers a really satisfying Metroidvania experience. Just you would expect from its level of production, the game has amazing platforming and deep combat system. I have to say, the combat looks incredibly fluid and flashy. It just looks really good, and I never get bored watching it. All in all, with its level of polish, Prince of Persia: The Lost Crown truly stands as one of the best, if not the best, Metroidvania to come out this year. That's all for today's list. Subscribe and like for more new exciting Metroidvania games. That's it, and see you next time!